Good morning. It is so good to have you here today. We want to welcome all of you who are visiting with us as participants in the music camp that we had this past week. We hope that you enjoy your experience here today. And if you happen to be looking for a church home, we hope that you will consider us as you look around. We want to welcome those people that are joining us by way of Facebook. It is good to have you with us too. We'll begin this morning by seeing if there are any announcements anybody would like to make. I see Fred over here in the wing. Oh, and Greg. Greg, you want to come on?
It's on.
It's on.
Good morning. My name is Fred Garrison. I'm chairman of the Finance Committee at church at Woodland. And I just want to bring you up to date on where we are with our receipts. Every summer, we have what we call the summer slump, where our receipts are not as high during the summer, but mostly because of vacations and people not being here. Well, this year, our slump is steeper than normal, and we're about a little over $21,000 short of where we were last year, and it's caused us a cash crunch. And my purpose is to ask you if there are any pledges that are not up to date, that we work to bring those up to date. And then also if there is anyone who is able and willing to give over and above what they normally do during this time and on into the rest of the year, we'd ask that you will consider doing that, because we need to have the money that we need to carry on our programs and pay our bills, and having a crunch this year. So thank you for what you've done already, and we look forward to any help that you might be able to give us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pastor Robert.
Sure.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning. Good morning.
First and foremost, as we've already said, thank you so much for coming, those of you that are our family already, and those of you who are coming for the music camp, and maybe hopefully continue to become our family. I wanted to let you know of a couple events we have coming up this summer. First off, we had a game night a couple of weeks ago. We had a few folks show up. It was a lot of fun. We're going to do another game night. I don't have the slide ready because we were a little busy this week. So, but on the 21st of July, which is a Sunday, we're going to do it Sunday this time, from 3 to 6, and I'll have a slide to confirm all that for next week. We're going to do another game night. So if you want to come out and just play some fun board games and card games here and just share some time together and some fellowship, come on out and see us. Bring a game, bring a snack, bring a friend, and we'll have a good time. Another thing I want to just point out, just kind of keep it in everybody's mind, we have our variety show that we're going to do in September. So, you know, think about that. Pray about it if you want to come and do something. And it doesn't have to be a big song and dance and something big. If you want to read a poem or tell a fun story, you know, this is all for our 75th anniversary. So if you have a fun story you want to share with everybody, let me know. We can put that in too. I'm going to have a sign-up sheet set up, not this week, but the following week, so folks can start signing up and we can start getting all that going. All right, so thank you guys for being here, and I'll get back to you.
All right, thank you so much. Are there any other announcements? It's kind of surprising not to see the choir up here. Yes. Yes. Okay, very good, very good. What prayer concerns do we have this week?
Jim Connor.
Yes, there was a group that left this morning from Woodland to go on a mission trip to West Virginia. So we want to pray that God will be with those youth and their leaders, that everybody has a meaningful time together. Jim and Jane Walters, Lucy Kate, Susie Kiesler, Debbie Bartle, Dennis Jones, Ingrid Erickson, Debbie Carey Carey, Bob King, okay. Well, hearing no others, I invite you to stand and share signs of Christ's peace with one another. This time, we invite you to turn your bulletin to the call to worship, and let us read this responsively. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases.
God's mercies are everlasting.
They are new every morning. Amen.
Thank you.
Please turn in your bulletin now to the morning prayer and let us pray together using these words. Steadfast God, you sent Jesus as a witness that no one is outside your healing reach. Help us to trust in the abundance of your love as we share your compassion and generosity wherever we may go, with you, in Christ, and through the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now let's continue by praying together the words of this special prayer that we have for Independence Day. Almighty God, you rule all the peoples of the earth. Inspire the minds of all women and men to whom you have committed the responsibility of government and leadership in all nations of the world. Give to them the vision of truth and justice, that by their counsel, all nations and peoples may work together. Give to the people of our country zeal for justice and strength for forbearance, that we may use our liberty in accordance with your gracious will. Forgive our shortcomings as a nation. Purify our hearts to see and love the truth. We pray all these things through Jesus Christ. Amen. Our hymn of celebration is found on page 140 in your United Methodist hymnal, page 140. If you're able, we invite you to stand as we sing. Now, turn to the back of your heavenly page. Apostles' Creed, page 881. Let us use our faith in God. People of God, what do you believe? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And now our hymn of reflection is America the Beautiful, which is on page 696, if you're using your hymnal, page 696. You may remain seated while we sing. This time we'll invite the ushers to come forward. Thank you. Almighty God, we thank you for the many blessings that you pour into our lives day after day. We are grateful for those blessings, and we are grateful for this opportunity to return to you your tithes and our offerings. We ask that you would accept these gifts, bless them, multiply them, and use them wherever they're needed in the world to build up your kingdom of heaven. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated.
do know we're going to school, right?
Of course, silly. We're at the bus stop.
Oh, come on, Seth. This is going to be a great day.
You're way too happy for a Monday morning.
I love Mondays. It's the start of a new week with new adventures.
Adventures? I don't think so. This is just another Monday.
Hey, you made it!
Late again, Chris?
Thank goodness you're all still here. I overslept.
I wonder why the bus is running late.
Oh, I hope I'm not late for class.
I don't care about being late for class, but I did want to see my friends before class starts.
Well, I'm glad the bus is late. Otherwise, I'd be in big trouble for missing it. So what's up with the sign?
What do you mean?
I mean the envelope stuck on the sign.
What? Wow, I didn't even see that there.
Me either. How did we miss that? I wonder what it is.
I don't know. Let's open it.
Wait a minute. That might not be for us.
Well, who else would it be for? We're the ones here every day.
I know, but it does seem strange, doesn't it? I mean, why would someone want us to know about a mission?
See, I told you today it was going to be filled with adventure. Let's open it.
Okay, I'll do it.
Good morning, kids. Your mission, should you choose to accept it, is Mark 6:15. This mission involves using your unique gifts and talents to share the good news with people all around you. For more information on what the good news is, see John 3:16. For more information on how to accomplish your mission, see Ephesians 2:10.
What's Mark 16:15 and all those other numbers?
Those are Bible verses. Hey, I still have my Bible in my backpack from Kids Club last night. I'll look them up. Mark 16:15, go into all the world and preach the gospel to all creation.
So that's our mission, go into all the world and preach?
I've never been out of state. And preach? I don't do that sort of thing.
Well, I have stage fright, so I'm not speaking in public.
So what are those other verses?
Well, I know John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. That must be the good news that the note mentioned.
So what's that other verse on there about?
Ephesians 2:10. For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do.
I remember another verse about God has given each one of us unique gifts to serve others. Kelsey, look up 1 Peter 4:10-11.
Made something special about each one of us. What was the last verse on the instructions, Annie?
Ephesians 2:10.
Can you repeat that one again, Kelsey? But God's handiwork? What is that supposed to mean?
Well, I don't know, but it sounds like God created each one of us with a special ability to carry out our mission.
Well, obviously, whoever gave us these instructions doesn't understand. We're just kids. Just ordinary people. What are we supposed to do?
I don't know, but God does have a habit of using ordinary people to do extraordinary things.
That's true. I mean, I've heard tons of Bible stories about God doing something amazing to accomplish his mission. Maybe he can do the same with us.
Water, far and wide. He got the
did some pretty incredible things, but that was a long time ago and pretty far away. Look on the other side of the world.
True, but the instructors did say go to Old World. Maybe we should get our passports in normal.
Our passports?
I don't think we need our passports. I know some people who go all the way around the world to tell others about Jesus. But I'm sure there are plenty of things we can do right here in our own neighborhood.
Like what?
Well, let's just think about all the people we see on a daily basis.
Right now, I'd just like to see the bus driver. I'm seriously going to be late for class. Where is he?
Hey, you were the one all excited for this adventure. Besides, if this mission keeps me from getting to school on time, then I'm all in.
Wait a minute, maybe that's where our mission is.
Where?
At school.
You might be right. Just think about all of our friends, our teachers, lots of people who might not know Jesus and what he's done.
That's true, but our mission can also be at all the other places we go today, or even at home and in our neighborhoods.
Wow, just think about all the people we can reach out to just a few blocks away from where we are right now. There are opportunities everywhere.
Contribute to this mission. I just don't know that there's anything special about me.
It sounds like God made something special about each one of us. What was the last verse of the instructions, Annie?
Ephesians 2:10.
Can you repeat that one again, Kelsey?
For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do.
I remember another verse about God has given each one of us unique gifts to serve others. Kelsey, look up from 1 Peter 4:10-11.
Okay, here it is.
Each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. If anyone speaks, they should do so as one who speaks the very words of God. If anyone serves, they should do so with the strength God provides, so that in all things God may be praised through Jesus Christ.
So if I'm going to talk to people, I should talk to them about Jesus. And if I'm going to help people, I should just help them somehow.
Basically, and if I'm good at encouraging other people that are upset or discouraged, I should do that.
Basically, I think God's telling us knew exactly what he was doing when he created us. And each one of us was created to do something that points people to him.
Bible talk about baseball? Because I'm pretty sure that's the only thing I'm good at.
I don't think the Bible talks specifically about baseball, but does talk about being a good friend to others and working at something as hard as you can. Maybe in baseball, you can encourage your teammates and show them how to be a good sport and things like that.
So what about you, Chris? What are you good at?
Well, music's kind of my thing, and I play guitar and sing a little too.
You're supposed to
use that?
Of course you can. You can sing and play songs that tell people about Jesus.
Okay, I don't know if this counts, but I'm actually pretty good at playing board games. Any chance God could use that?
Of course. There's a nursing home just down the street, and my grandma lives there. She loves board games.
Really? I never thought of that.
Maybe we should go visit her together sometime.
But none of this is really preaching the gospel, is it?
I think preaching means more than just using words. It takes action, too. I think it all comes down to us showing love to people. And we can show love in lots of different ways.
And once we show love to lots of people, then we can tell more and more people about Jesus.
This mission we've been given.
Agreed, but we still don't know who left its envelope for us in the first place.
And we also don't know why the bus is so late.
Hey, here comes our bus now. Good grief, we are going to be late.
Hi, kids. Sorry for the delay. I got a call this morning that my bus was in the shop, so I had to go pick it up before I started my route. I knew I was going to be late, so I left a note for you. Did you get it?
No, all we got was this note about a mission.
Yes, that's the note I left you.
You left this for us?
Yep. I thought it might give you something to think about before you head off to school. I know Monday mornings can be tough sometimes, and you might not realize that every single day there's a purpose and plan for your life. Every day, God has you doing certain things. It's all about your mission. Your mission to show love to people and tell them the good news.
Well, I did not see this coming.
Me either. But thanks. You really opened our eyes to what ordinary kids like us can do every day to help serve and preach the gospel.
Well, that's good news, too. Okay, kids, are you ready to get moving?
Yeah, let's go!
Thank you to our children and Pam, Greg, all those that helped.
Yes. Thank you so much for coming today. Let's hear it again for this wonderful group of children. We have had a fantastic week. If you can imagine learning a 30-minute musical, 25, 27, 30, somewhere in there, musical in 5 days, and you can also imagine if you've worked with children at all, we didn't spend those 5 hours working just on music. We did other stuff too, so they did a fantastic job. We had so much fun, and we would like to thank the parents who I know have encouraged them to work at home, and they did so well. We're just so proud of them and so excited that we could have this camp again at our church this summer. I would like to remind you that this is not a one-person or a two-person show. It takes a village to do things like this. And so if you had anything to do with camp this week and you are here today, if you were a volunteer every single day, if you cooked and brought food here for lunches, if you just came by and said, hey, to see everybody, would you please stand so that everybody can see? We've got Bruce upstairs who are helping with the sand. We've got lots of other people standing around and in the back and everything. So thank you so much to all the volunteers. most importantly, thank you to the children who came every day. These children came every day. They did all the things we asked them to do, mostly. And even if they didn't, we still had a fun time, and we enjoyed it. We have certificates for each one of them and a little treat bag just because they deserve it and more, but we are so proud of them. So I'm going to take the time, if you don't mind, to call them forward to give them their certificate so that you can see who they are, and we are so grateful. So when I call your name, come down here, Miss Gregg and Miss Meredith, Miss Betty Jean, Miss Audrey. These are the people who are here and helping us every day. So if you'll please just come down, they'll show you where. Penny, you'll come down first. Penny Addix. Cooper Antonucci. Seth Kerlock. Eleanor Carter. Miriam Carter. London Haynes. Gabriel Mackey. Solomon Mackey. Lillian Maitland. Liam Mannion. Lincoln Mannion. Judah Moncrief. Alexander Patterson. Alex Rode. Allison Valente. Thank you so much, parents, for bringing them here every day, and we are just so proud of them. And I hope that if you do not have a church home, that you would consider Woodland and join us. Come any Sunday and stay tuned for camp next summer.
Our closing hymn this morning is found on page 697 in the hymnal. If you're able, please stand as we sing. Thank you.
we thank all of you for being here today and thank our children for the music. We now will go in the grace and peace of God out into the world to love every person we meet as though we were meeting Jesus himself. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.